episode of Muscles and Mowers. Today we're going to be cleaning the carburetor out on 5-horsepower Bridgman Stratton. A pretty common lawnmower. Most of the mowers out there have this engine on them. It's better known as plastic carb. And yeah, it needs service every once in a while. This one here, you start it up, it shuts down. It runs for a few seconds, shuts down. Sometimes another common thing for them, they'll start, they'll run for a few minutes, and then they'll bog out, or they just won't have full power. So if your lawnmower is doing that, we're going to show you how to fix that yourself without taking it to the shop.
All right, to get the carburetor off, first thing we're going to do, I'm going to pull the air cleaner cover off, pull the air filter. All right, now 8mm on top. And then you're gonna have 2 8mm bolts here. Then you're gonna have 2 7mm bolts here. That's it. Pull this off. Keep your bolts. Just gonna pull the cover off. Take this off as one assembly. Slide the tank off. And then just wiggle her out. That's it. That right there. Okay, we're back. Now I got the carburetor, took it off the tank, the 7mm bolt. Pull that there, pull that there. Now to separate the carburetor, separate the bottom. Okay, that's really all you do. Get that off there with a flathead. Now, this is the problem right here. This is your tower. That's the main jet where all the gas goes through. You're gonna use a flathead, just pry that up. It's really the only problem on these carburetors. You don't really have to mess with that too much. Now, if you can see, there's a lot of dirt right there. Normally that'd be the color, it'd be a brass color. You'd see the metal. Same right here. Gas comes through, it gets a little dirty. That dirt right there will make this carburetor not run. It'll make this lawnmower not run. Also, there's a little gap right here. You wanna make sure, squeeze that tight. Now we're gonna get into cleaning. Okay, I use welding torch tip cleaners. The main thing with these, I take a torch tip cleaner, and then I cut them right there on a 45. It's going to help you get this carburetor clean. Now, how you do this, get the flat side right there, and you just go around the edge. Make sure you get the whole thing. Don't miss any. You're basically just sanding down the metal. Get all the dirt off it. Okay, now I'm going to clean the rim here. And then pull some of that stuff out. Alright, I'm going to get my trusty carburetor cleaner here. Put it in the bottom. Okay, now we got clogged up right here in the center, so we're gonna use a smaller torch tip cleaner. I'm gonna sand down the edge. Let's go around a couple times, pull that out. Let's try it again. Now we get much better flow. Okay, we're gonna do the same thing to the bottom. Get the whole thing. This little spot there. Spare it in a little bit. I'm going to do the same thing here. Time. Now if you have a compressor, use a little compressed air. It helps. And if you look at that, you can see it. It's a lot cleaner. It's a will start right up now. Now I put the carburetor back together. Before I put it together, just give us a spray right here. Just make sure it's coming out. Now put the tower back in. Push her down. Okay. That back in. 2 bolts. Okay, 7mm. And that's it. She's done.
Now, one thing I'd like to point out, right here on the intake tube, you're going to find 2 washers that come off the carburetor when you take it off. You got to pull those out, and you got to put them back in the carburetor before you put it on. Now, the black one, that goes first. That sits inside that ridge right there. Here, the white one goes in second. Make sure it snaps in. And then just reverse the process, put it back together, and see if she works.
All right, let's see how we did.
Well, thanks for tuning in. Please like, share, and follow if you want to see more Muscles.